afternoon all. Just come up to 2 o'clock on Sunday afternoon. I'm back down here on Patapool on the White Acres complex in Newquay, Cornwall, for another week-long session. Got down around about midday yesterday afternoon and was greeted by torrential rain. Absolutely lashed it down for about 4 or 5 hours yesterday afternoon. But pleased to say it did stop, and we managed to get ourselves sorted and pop into the town and do a bit of shopping, etc. I've got down the lake this morning, 11:30 I think it was. Had a quick scout around on Patspool. There's one or two bodies dotted around, which is a major contrast to this time last year when I was virtually the only one on the lake. I've got to be honest with you, I was very surprised to see that this swim was vacant. So a quick scout around and decided to start off where I left off, basically. I'm fishing 3 rods. You can probably just see the butt sticking out there behind this patch of reeds. I've got a citrus pop-up, a white one, that's presented on a multi-rig over 2 or 3 good handfuls of my Stodgeboardy Approach 4G squid, which I'll go into depth more during the week. The middle rod is fished right in the central area of the lake. That's presenting one of the new Key Cray cultured up baits. That's fished over a good 2 or 3 handfuls of stabilised boilie stodge. And last but not least, the left hand rod is fished just a bit further on down, central over the lake again. That's fished on, using a snowman rig, a Cray, Key Cray bottom bait and one of my fresh orange tippers to make a snowman, and that's fished once again over a good 2 or 3 handfuls of Stodge Boilie Approach. The boilies I'm using in 2 sizes, 15s and 10s, just to try and create a little bit more confusion, hopefully, for the fish that visit the spots, and try and make it a bit more difficult for them so they don't know which one obviously has got the rigging. What can I say? Following catch reports over the last, 4 to 6 weeks on the Facebook page, that's the Whiteacres Facebook page, it's not been fishing particularly well, Pat's Ball. They've been having 1 or 2 fish down Nelson's, but Pat's has been fishing very hard indeed. Had numerous tweets yesterday afternoon from people who'd who've been on here the last 2 or 3 weeks, and they were saying the same thing. And literally just as I left the caravan this morning, I was halfway down the track and a bloke approached me and we had a chin wag, and he said, "Mate, I'd turn round and I wouldn't even bother," which I found a bit of a strange remark, to be quite honest. But in a nutshell, he said exactly the same thing: it's not fishing very well at all. But as they say, you've got to be in it to win it, and with a rod in the water, that's half the battle. I think we're going to have a mixed bag of weather, looking at the long-range forecast on the Met Office website. Majority of the day it's saying it's going to start off like this, which is windy and sunny, and as the day goes on, we're going to get a few showers, and they're going to increase late afternoon. But you know as well as I do, things can change rapidly, and the weather forecasts are not always accurate. Having a quick scout round, as I said earlier, I have seen fish move, and I'm pleased to say they've been on my side of the lake. I've seen at least 3 or 4 shows as I was tackling up and getting everything sorted, so that's encouraging. And I shall take the same approach as I did last year, which is, with it being cold mornings, I'll get down the lake around about 11, 12 o'clock, hopefully, with my theory being the sun out and it'll just raise the water temperature by a degree or so, and I will fish into dark a couple of hours, so I ain't going to do anything different there. And it'll be interesting to see how the old Key Cray does on this venue. Fortunate to be testing it for Nash. I've had quite a few fish in the last 3 or 4 weeks down my club lake. I'm on nearly 20 fish. They've really got their heads down on that one, and it's been a success down there. But this is the second menu I've brought it to, and today is my first outing, so I'm interested to see what response that gets on here. I did quite well on the key on here last year. That 26-pound ghosty which I finished on, which was ended up being the biggest capture of the week, fell to a key pop-up on a multi-big, so is hoping the old key crow is going to do even better. So I've not long put the kettle on and made myself a brew. So I'm going to sit back and enjoy that, watch the water, and update as we go along. So Sunday, first day of a week-long session. Fingers crossed, I'll have plenty of updates and one or two carp to show you. Catch up you later, folks.
Smack on 6 o'clock, my left hand has absolutely melted off, and I've just gone and bagged the first one of the session. Key Crow Snowman rig with one of my little yellow fresh orange juice pop-ups on the top, over about 2 or 3 handfuls of Key Crow bottom baits. And I'm going to slip the net under a lovely mirror, just gone 22.5 pound, bit of a tatty mouth, it's sad to report, but apart from that, she's beautiful. Just gone and dropped it in the edge. Well, I've got everything sorted. I have got my mat here, folks. But there you go. That's better. Beautiful fish. A really spirited battle under the rod tip. But a slight tatty mouth, which I'll add a bit of carp care to it before I slip it back to a watery home, but superb. I might even go back and have my tea. Mind you, there's a few fish moving around, so I could be tempted to stay for an hour into dark. But yeah, nice to get off to a start on the first day. There's a coot just darts out the margin. There we go, Key Crow Snowman rig has bagged me the first one of the session, 22.5 pound, of Pat's Paul Mirror. Beautiful.
Well, morning all, it's Monday morning. We're coming up to 12 o'clock. And as you can see by this shot, we've been greeted with a beautiful morning. There is one or two showers knocking around, but nothing like yesterday evening. Blimey, after I returned that fish, which was around about 20 past 6 after I'd done a few stills and a bit of video, the heavens well and truly opened up and I got absolutely soaked to the skin. I was planning on going straight back to the caravan and scrapping fishing into dark beans. I caught that fish, but I had no chance but to stay put. It absolutely teamed it down, and I went back happy but absolutely soaked. But it's all part of the fun, isn't it? Back in the same swim as I was yesterday. The two rods there are back on the same spots, presenting the same baits as yesterday. And the only change I've made is that one there, which was presenting the old multi-rig and the 15mm white citrus pop-up over Stodge 4G squid. That one was placed up against that island yesterday, but to be honest with you, the ducks absolutely drove me mad yesterday. They cleared me out and I got picked up 2 or 3 times. And during yesterday I did spot fish showing in the little gap there where the rope comes across to meet the two islands. So I've stuck it on there, and we're going to kick start the session off today with that rod anyway on that spot, and let's see if that produces anything today. So there you go, that's the scene, as I say, coming up to midday. Let's see what today has in store. Hopefully a few more carp.
Right then, not long after I finished the opening blog post of the day, same rod's gone that went last night. Bit of a funny take this one. It kind of like pulled up tight, then it dropped back. Another one on the key cray with one of my little yellow fresh orange juice pop-up tippers over about three handfuls of key cray bottom baits. And I've had a lovely ghosty, just gone on the scales, registered 19.5 pounds. There we go, folks. Look at that. It's my second ghosty out of Pat's Pool. I had one last year, 26 pound. This one's his little son or daughter, 19.5 pound. Beautiful fish. Another one on the old key cray. Could only been hanging for about, what, 45, 50 minutes. So quick action. And nice to start the second day with another fish in the bag. Right then, pop her back, get the old rod sorted, get it back on the spot and try and bag another one. Chuffed to bits. Afternoon all, it's just approaching 25 to 1 on Tuesday. Different swim today. The swim that I was intending in getting back in the swim that I've been in the last couple of days, but two people have beat me to it today, so fair play to them. They're fishing that swim that I was in and the one next to it. I think they're a couple, so yeah, fair play to them. There's quite a few anglers dotted around the lake today. I think I've counted 5 on my recce. Look around the lake, so there's plenty of lines in the water. But if you've ever been to Pat's Pool before, just as you walk into to the lake, past Sycamore Lake, right where the sign is, there's a lovely lovely swim there, just on the corner, right in the dip. I stood here for about 10-15 minutes. I've spotted fish in this area. The wind's trickling in here, lovely. You might just be able to see it on the screen there and listen to the wind blowing in the background. And the big factor is it's well away from all the pressure. There's virtually everybody's fishing a minimum of 2 rods and up to 3 rods. So decision made. I've dropped in here. Same rigs and baits as I've been using all week. The only change that I've been forced in making is, you might notice there, my rod on the single bank stick, which is pointing directly in front of them pads. That there is a dwarf and not a scope. Can't believe it. I pulled up with the barra first thing and I got down to the water's edge to have a good look around. I heard a white crash bang and a wallop. I've looked round and my barra was tipped over and unfortunately one of the scopes got damaged and the tip section broke, so absolutely gutted. But I brought that dwarf for that very reason. If there's ever a problem in with any of the rods, I've got a spare. So yeah, a bit gutted, but not to worry. I'll get on the phone to Nash when I get back home and get a replacement. But yeah, there we go. Dwarf is placed on I've placed my multi-rig on the old 15mm white citrus pop-up again over Stodge Boilie, right on the tip of the pads there. If I zoom in, you'll see where I've just placed the bait. And encouragingly, I've seen the pads move a few times and it was fizzing, and I did see one cruise across the surface, so that is very, very encouraging. The left-hand rod is placed in between the bank and the island there, a bit of a channel, where from where I was fishing yesterday, I did see fish crash. So we've dropped a key cray snowman presentation right in the middle there, and the other rod is on the tip of the island. That's on a key cray culture duck bait over a Stodge stabilised key. So traps are set, I'm all settled in, and let's see what today has got in store. Can we make it 3 carp in 3 days? Only time will tell.
Westland 20 to 4. And the old multi rig presenting the citrus pop up just rattled off. I ain't gonna mess about too much with this one. First common of the trip and the third capture. And without doubt, the smallest fish we've had so far. Rough estimate, I don't know, 14, 15 pound. But they're all welcome, so might do a few quick match shots and then slip her back and get the rod back out. Lovely. Morning. Wednesday morning. Just approaching 11:45. And I've just about got everything sorted and dropped all three rods back on the spots in the same swim I was in yesterday. A nice sight when I arrived, I was greeted to fizzing. All down this margin here. And I did debate just dropping a rod right on it before I got everything settled. But sod's law, got everything sorted and the fizzing dispersed. So I've left that on the back burner for the time being. And I will possibly introduce a few free offerings during the session, just to see if anything comes back on that spot. Made one change today, and that's the middle rod. It's back on the point of that island, but I've taken off the key Cray cultured up bait and I've popped on one of the bright pink citrus bottom baits and give it a good old spray. Still fished over the stabilised key, so just going to try something a little bit different. But fished into dark to around about 8 o'clock last night and nothing else happened. So day 4, another target, can we make it 4 fish in 4 days? Not many anglers on the lake this morning compared to yesterday. So less anglers, less lines and less pressure. Right, as always, I'll update in due course.
There you go, folks. Capture number 4 of the trip, 17.5 pound. This one fell to the pink citrus bottom bait, fished over stabilised key. Hell of a scrap. Lovely fish. So that's 4 fish now and 3 mirrors. Lovely. Have a quick look at the other side. Right then, don't know an exact time, it's around about 6 maybe, 10 past 6, but the rod on the single bank stick near the pads has just rattled off again. Bit of a jittery, funny take, but I've gone and bagged the biggest of the trip so far, capture number 5, little white citrus pop up on a twisted multi-rig over my Stodge 4G squid, and this time I added a few Key Cray bottom baits, and just popped you on the scales and this one's gone 26.5 pound. Lively again, it's been in the margin for about 5 minutes, but this one is showing off its winter colours, well, early autumn stroke winter colours, and it's got a right set of shoulders on it. I'll just calm it down for a bit, folks, and I'll show you. There we go. It's the biggest one of the trip so far. Look at the colours on that. A real tussle towards the net. You really have to drag them out near them pads. But I would say the fight only lasted about 3 or 4 minutes. Real hustle and bustle. But I'm pleased to say she's all mine. Look at that. this fish has got the potential to grow really big. Look at the frame on it. 26.5 pounds. White citrus pop up again. As I just said, on the old twisted multi-rig over a Stodge 4G squid and about 5 or 6 50mm of the new Key Cray boilies. Absolutely chuffed.
Evening folks, it's just after 6 o'clock and the only thing I've got to report is it's been an absolutely beautiful day weather wise. But on the carp front, it's been very quiet indeed. I've had a single bleep on that rod, and I had a single bleep, which is the one I think I captured on film early this afternoon. About half an hour ago, I did see a fish crash literally in between the rods, and it was the smallest carp I think I've seen all week. It must have been about 3 or 4 pounds, but it jumped out the water at least 4 or 5 times. I've seen nobody else catch a fish on the lake. There's one or two starting to pack up now, so I could possibly be the only one on the lake into darkness, which I'm going to stick it out. Fish till at least 8 o'clock I think. Those rods have not moved, and they will not be moved. I have topped these two rods up with a few fresh baits. Oh, there we go, that's the first fish I've seen show, well, a proper fish I should say, right in the open water. Yeah, what was I saying? Yeah, I've topped those two rods back up. I haven't put a lot of bait in, and I've only topped them up with about 3 or 4 free offerings. So there we go. So it's been an absolutely gorgeous day, but there is a slight chill in the air now, and there was a guy who literally walked past me about 20 minutes ago and had a rat with him and his missus. He's got a caravan on site and he does come down here quite a lot, and he just told me tonight we could possibly have a frost. So hopefully he's wrong there, but there certainly is a nip in the air as we're as I'm talking to you. So hopefully something's going to materialise before I depart from yet another day's angling here at Whiteacres. But if I do go home today with a dry net, I can't really complain, can I, over the last 5 days. I had some good sport and fish up to 26 pounds, so as I say, I'm going to stick it out till about 8 o'clock. And if anything does happen, I'll do my best to get it on film for you. But if it doesn't, I'll be back out tomorrow for the final day of the session. And I think I'm going to go back down to Pat's Pool. But yep, still a few hours left of today, so I'm going to get my best shot and hopefully try and bag one for the camera. Morning all, it's just a shade past 11 a.m. and I'm back on Pat's Pool in the pad swim for the final day of the session. Stuck it out last night till 8 o'clock. But unfortunately, nothing materialised, and I finished yesterday on a blank. Weather-wise, it was fantastic, but the only thing I caught yesterday was a tan. It was quite a grueling day. So I've decided to come back down to Pat's, and this swim was vacant, so I've jumped straight in it. And I've got the rods back out in the usual spots. One thing I will add, last night went really, really cold, and when we awoke this morning, everything was covered in frost. So that could play a big part today. And it's not exactly full of light in this corner. Certainly where the single rod is, it's quite shaded, so I think the forecast said it's going to it's going to be like this all day, and it is going to get into double figures around about 13-14 degrees. So hopefully that'll just raise the water temperature and get one or two fish moving. As always, I'll give it my best shot, but if nothing else happens today, I can't really complain. I've had a fantastic week. Really do enjoy my sessions down here at Whiteacres. So we're currently on 5 fish. The biggest one was the one I had on, let me think, Wednesday, at 26 pound. And the smallest one I've had was that little common, which I didn't weigh, was around about 15 or 16 pound. So fingers crossed one more graces the bank before we leave tomorrow morning. And as always, if anything materialises or anything of interest, I'll get it in the blog. I'm going to stick it out till dark again tonight. So I'll update you in due course. Breakfast on the bank this morning. I've been eating in the caravan all most of the mornings before I venture down to the lakes. But I fancied having a nice sausage and bacon sandwich and a cup of coffee on the bank today, just to add to the experience. So I'm going to crack on with that, and I'll see you later. Right then, whilst we've got a break in the action, I think I did say early in the week I would go through and show you how I prepare my what I call stodge boilie approach. Have a quick butchers in there. These have been prepared and fermented for, I think it was a good week or so. And to make it, it's dead simple really. I mean, I'm using 4G squid and the key. You can do this with any bait that's on the market, providing they obviously do a matching liquid food dip and a stick mix. So the first step is just to get yourself a quality freezer bag. And freezer bags are the best option in my opinion, because they're quite strong. So I roughly add about a kilo of bottom bait straight to the bag. And then using the liquid food dip, I normally add 2 capfuls to the boilies and give the bag a real good shake about. And then I just add the matching stick mix, and it's up to you how much you want to add on the actual baits. I normally add about 3 handfuls and then just gradually add a little bit more. Sometimes it depends how many baits are in there, and how I feel, to be quite honest. And just give it a real good shake about. Initially you'll get quite a liquidy, sloppy mix, but a good 24 hours and longer, the stick mix really does stodge up, and you tend to get baits like that. So you imagine in there I've got 15s and 10mm baits. So that goes in with a real plonk, almost like ground bait. And then over a period of time, the stick mix breaks down, leaving 3 offerings in the water, and little particles keep breaking off and rising through the water column during the session on your spot. Been using it now for about a month, and I think it's a big edge, I really do. I think when the carp come in and they find it, in my opinion, it just keeps them in the area and scavenging and hunting and digging the bottom just that little bit longer than it would be just adding conventional boilies. So as I say, I use Nash bait. On this session I've been using the key and 4G squid, but you can do this approach with any baits, providing they do a matching glug and a stick mix. So thought you might just want a bit of a heads up on my stodge boilie approach. Give it a go, folks, it's worth a bash.
Well, it's the final day of the session and the rods haven't been out for longer than an hour. Tip of the island, single pink citrus bottom bait over the new key cray. I literally just finished my sandwich, first lurp of the coffee, and it's belted off. Haven't weighed it, I don't know, £14, maybe £15, but Who cares? Look at the scales on that one. Great condition. Chuffed. That's capture number 6.